الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه، أعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. Welcome dear brothers, dear sisters, inshallah we'll continue our blessed journey with the Holy Quran, Surah Yunus, the Surah 109 verses. It is Makki Surah. We're still in the verse number 49, inshallah we'll cover this ayat tonight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal said this ayat, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, verse number 49, قل لا أملك لنفسي ضرا ولا نفعا إلا ما شاء الله لكل أمة أجل إذا جاء أجلهم فلا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون. This ayah comes after the previous ayah when the infidels they asked Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم for the punishment. The previous ayah 48 said ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين. They asked Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم let us know tell us when that time gonna come when Allah gonna punish us your God. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam politely, he told them that قل, Allah told Rasulullah to tell them قل من سيّ محمد sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to them I have no power. قل لا أملك لنفسي ضرّا ولا نفع. I have no power over any harm or benefit. This is Rasulullah. Nowadays you see people, fortune tellers and psychic people and the karbani dealing with jinn and they claim they know the future, they knew the unseen and all of that. Allah is telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي ضَرًّا وَلَا نَفْعًا. Tell them, يا محمد عليه السلام, I have no power over any harm or benefit to myself except what Allah may grant me. For every nation or people, there is an appointed time, لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ أَجَلٍ. When their time comes, neither can they advance or delay it a moment or hour. طيب, let's see. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, guys, I am free من الحول والقوة. I have no capability. In certain things, I don't have power over anything, any harm or benefit. Allah is the one who can harm and he can benefit. Even Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلا أملك لنفسي, I don't have any power, like حول ولا طول. الحول means what? التصرف في الأشياء, قدرة. Sometimes I'm not capable to take care of even myself. Allah don't take care, he takes care of me. والدليل, they stone him in الطائف صلى الله عليه وسلم. What did he do? He was crying and tearing and tearing. سبحان الله. He human, عليه الصلاة والسلام. They drove him out of Mecca, عليه الصلاة والسلام, after the death of خديجة and أبو طالب. See, فهي said I cannot, يعني I have no حول. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Allah the one who has الحول والطول. الطول means the power, غنى. I'm not even rich. This طول. الحول means the power. Sometimes I ask Allah to help me. فهو صلى الله عليه وسلم his job to deliver that message which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to him. And he cannot benefit, he cannot harm, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of this in the hand of Allah, in the feast of Allah, in the power of Allah, under the control of Allah. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is al-khaliq, he is the only creator. And ala lahu al-amru wal-khalq. Allah said that in the Quran. The amr, the order, belongs to Allah. He's the one who can give the command and the amr. And he said wal-khalq, he's the only creator too. يبقى اللي يخلق هو اللي يأمر. The only one he can give amr, the creator, because he's the creator. أَلَا لَهُ الْأَمْرُ أَوْ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ وَالْخَلْقُ. والله سبحانه وتعالى, everything under his will and مشيئة. And this ayah, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he sent it to Rasulullah, verse number 94, after the verse number 48, when they asked for hastening the punishment. It is not in my hand. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم did. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Yes. They ask it, they hasten for the punishment, making fun or mocking Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they said, يلا, tell us what is the punishment. We are waiting for the punishment of your God. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he came to his people like any prophet and messenger, he came with the miracle. عليه الصلاة والسلام to deliver المنهج, the certain message. And some of them they believe in, on him. Some of them they denied him صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the one who can judge between them, Allah عز وجل, not me and you. In the day of judgment, even in dunya, Allah will humiliate them, the kuffar, those who denied Rasul. In the hereafter, if they die in this same condition, situation, they will be punished also in the hereafter. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, he's the one who can grant victory to the mu'mineen, and the one he defeats the kafiri. And they said, for each nation and people and ummah, there is an appointed time. ولكل أمة أجل. It's written already. It is not in the hand of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. والأجل, that appointed time, could be the time, their time, appointed time in this worldly life, in dunya, or appointed time in the grave, or appointed time in the earth, or appointed time where, in the hereafter too. قال, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about women when her husband died, فَإِذَا بَلَغْنَ أَجَلَهُنَّ أَجَلَهُنَّ, or her husband divorced her. But mostly this ayah about that lady, which is woman, her husband died. فَإِذَا بَلَغْنَ أَجَلَهُنَّ, الأجل means the مُدَّة. What is the مُدَّة? A lady asked me that yesterday, that مُدَّة of الْعِدَّة, if her husband died, 4 months and 10 days. What women or Muslim women should do? Yeah, she can go outside for necessity, feeding her kids, going to the doctor, doing something important, and she's not supposed to talk to any men during that time. It's not because she's pregnant or not. Out of respect to her husband, because he died. Not just that, out of respect, not because of the pregnancy, you know. And also the scholar, they make a research about that. They said each man, he has his fingerprint on the womb of his wife that will disappear from her body after 4 months and 10 days, as if she never married before. That's why those who are making zina, adultery, their body get confusion, because that too many fingerprints in her womb, in her vagina. That's why she gets sick. Her body cannot have immune system anymore. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he put that system or the law or the system of Islam, the rules, this is for the maintenance of our body, for our benefits, subhanallah. فَإِذَا بَلَغْنَ أَجَلَهُنَّ, what is the ajal of the المدة, appointed time for a woman when her husband died? 4 months and 10 days. After that she can marry. طيب. والله سبحانه وتعالى, he created the man, خلق الإنسان مقهور, being forced in certain way, and he has also choice in certain way. For the تكليف, التكليف to do good or bad, to come to the masjid to pray or not, to be kafir or Muslim or mu'min, this is up to your choice. Allah said that, فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. You have a choice. If you want to be a mu'min, it's so up to you. But if you want to be a kafir also, it's up to you. But I want you, don't be happy. Because some people said, see, Islam gave us the choice. Don't be happy. Read the rest of the ayah. فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ نَارًا حاط بهم سرادقها. If you want to be kafir, wait for the fire. It's waiting for you. Allah said in the rest of the verse, we are preparing for the zalimin, the kafirin, nar, fire. They will be surrounded by it. حاط بهم سرادقها. طيب. فأنت حر. You're free. Do whatever you want. Do whatever you want. You see, remember when we were in the kindergarten, elementary school, middle school, even high school, we're being controlled by the timing, by the class, by the teacher, and all of that. When you go to the college, you are free. Yes, they give you the time, and this is up to you. You want to go, go. You don't want to go to the college, it's up to you. In the end, if you did not study, you did not make your duty, you're going to lose. You're going to fail. That's why they leave you free after when you became in the college? Because you are mature enough now. You're not a little kid still. Little kid must be controlled in the elementary school, in the public, in the high school. They're still little kids. They have to be controlled by the class, by the timing, by the manhaj, whatever they said, the curriculum and all of that stuff. For that's why now you have the choice and you are mature and Allah will count you. تحر. The benefits of being obedient is going to come to you, not to Allah Azza wa Jal. You cannot harm Allah, you cannot benefit Allah. And the harm of being disobedient is going to come against you. لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. That's it. If somebody, for example, he executed himself hang himself to die. Do you think he can harm Allah? Where is the harm is going to go? To him. First of all, he died as a kafir. I cannot say kafir, astaghfirullah. No, he's not a kafir. Still saying la ilaha illallah with a major sin. You know, but a very big major sin because he killed himself. You know? Subhanallah. And he has a special punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, فالعباد دائما يعجلون والله لا يعجل. These people, they were hastening the punishment. Allah لا يعجل بعجلة أحدكم. You are hastening, you're crying for certain dua, for certain thing. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about it. And maybe if Allah gave it to you immediately, just like, because you doesn't understand, you don't know, but Allah knows. Maybe you're going to harm yourself. Ya Rab, I need a lot of money. Brother Rahir, remember Thalaba, the vision of the masjid? He used to come behind the Imam every Salah, behind Rasulullah. And even this hadith is weak, but I take it, the Mufassirin, they said it. Thalaba, Ibn Hatib, or whatever his name, said, Ya Rasulullah, ask Allah for more sheep and more lamb. Ya Rasulullah, I am poor. Said, Ya Rasulullah, said, you're good, Ya Thalaba. You're praying with me, you sit with me all the time in the masjid. Stay. Said, Ya Rasulullah, please make dua for me. Allah give him more money and sheep and lamb and give. Bullock his sheep and subhanallah and cattle it was filling the streets of Al-Madina. He took it away outside one of the valleys of Al-Madina. And what happened to him? He's not coming to the Salah anymore. Even when he became super rich because of the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Kharban, they used to call him Hamamat al-Masjid, the vision of the masjid. He used to come before Rasulullah to the Salah. When he became super rich, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent somebody to take zakah from him. He said, no, I will not. You know, he used to delay it. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he regret, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked him, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I will give you my zakah. Rasulullah said, no. Quran came about you. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهِ لَيْنْ أَتَاهُمْ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَا صَدَّقَانَ. They make an oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah give us, we're going to give sadaqah. Already give them. Allah make them rich, enrich them. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he rejected his sadaqah. He said, no, you are kafir anymore, khalas. I will not take sadaqah from you anymore. He tried to give it to Abu Bakr, Abu Bakr refused it. Alayhi salatu radiallahu anhu. He tried to give it to Sayyidina Umar, Umar said, no. Rasul and Abu Bakr, they did not take it from you. How can I take it? You're kafir already, Quran came about you. That's why Sahaba, this is scare. If they make any sin, they used to run to Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, make this, please. Ask Allah not to send the Quran about me. This is scare. Al-Wahi is coming. Yes, ala tawr. Fish li'al. فالله is not hastening by your like you. وَيَدْعُ الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاءُ بِالْخَيْرِ. He doesn't know what he's saying. He doesn't know. Maybe he's asking for something and that can harm him and he doesn't know. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. وَالْعَاجِلَ, it's opposite of الْآجِلَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَ. الْعَاجِلَ الدُّنْيَا, this world. We love it so much. What about الآخرة? We are heedless about it. Allah said, سَأُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِي فَلَا تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. I will show you my miracles, my verses, my qudra, capability in this universe. And don't hasten it. Don't hasten. Wait. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is delaying the punishment out of His mercy to us. وَإِذَا جَاءَ الْأَجَلُ أَجَلُهُمْ لَا يُؤَخَّرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ, when their appointed time comes, لَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. Sa'a explained yesterday, it's a short time. Not it's the hour, 60 minutes, no. Sa'a means short time. It cannot be delayed for 1 second and moment. Verse number 50, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ. Now Allah is questioning them. You are hastening the punishment? Wait. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَتَاكُمْ عَذَابُهُ بَيَاتًا أَوْ نَهَارًا مَاذَا يَسْتَعْجِلُ مِنْهُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. Ya Allah, look at this ayah. Say, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the infidels, those who are disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal, those who are hastening Allah's punishment, tell me, Rasul is telling them, the way Allah said them, tell them, Ya Rasulullah, tell me, if Allah's torment comes to you, punishment, at night or by day, why at night? Well, you are heedless and sleeping. You cannot even do anything. What about during the day while you are busy in this dunya, occupied with dunya? And in reality, every time it's a day and night. It's a night here in America, California, Middle East is the morning there. In India is morning there, right? فسبحانallah, all the time is day and night. And the punishment, when the punishment comes, but there is a point here where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when they hastened his punishment, he said, tell me if the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to you while you are sleeping or while you are occupied, busy in this dunya. And this is stupidity from them. Ya akhi, yani, I don't know, this people, they ask it, somebody's asking for the punishment. It's a stupidity. And you're not asking human like you, you're asking Allah to send the punishment. Yeah, you are challenging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. في الحقيقة, يعني, reality, يعني, we have to know that if the punishment comes to them suddenly, sudden punishment, what are they going to do while they are sleeping? Or while they are busy, subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the punishment, if the punishment comes, sudden punishment to you, is there any time for you to declare your iman, to say we believe? There is no time because it comes baghta, sudden. Like exactly Fir'aun, Afandi. Mr. Fir'aun, عليه اللعنة. Fir'aun, هذا الحقير, الفير'عون, I will read it in the Quran, فير, see somebody say, Fir'aun, why you make him great? Fir'aun, الراء must be soft when you recite it. Fir'aun, something has no value. Fir'aun, فرعون, with 100,000 soldiers in the morning, was following Musa عليه السلام. While Musa with Ben Israel standing on the edge of the Red Sea, and they said, Ya Musa, inna lamudrakun, you are a troublemaker. Ben Israel, they said to Musa like that. Inna, you are a troublemaker. You are the one who put us in this problem. And instead of making dua or listening to their Nabi, they were kharbanin too. And Sayyidina Musa said, Kalla, nay, inna ma'ya Rabbi sayahdeen. Allah with me and Allah will guide me. You didn't see any miracles before. So I showed you too many things. Listen. Allah with me. They saw the dust of 100,000 soldiers with Fir'aun. You know this, the rest of the story, how Allah saved the Bani Israel and destroyed the army, 100,000 soldiers of Fir'aun, and Allah saved the body of Fir'aun. Not Fir'aun, his body. فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةٌ. Today we're going to save your body to be a sign, ayah, for those who are coming behind you until the day of judgment. And his bodies laying where? In the museum of Cairo until now. You can see him as he died yesterday. Subhanallah. Why? It's a sign. It's an ayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For now, Fir'aun, he comes to the point, he said, I believe. I believe. He said, قَالَ آمَنْتُ أَنَّهُ I believe. أَنَّهُ There is no God except the God of Bani Israel. He did not say even my God. He's حيوان. يعني he was even arrogant when he said that word. قال آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل. I believe in the God of Bani Israel. God of Bani Israel. Well, he's not your God still. And you say you believe. أثم Allah answered him. أثم إذا ما وقع آمنتم به الآن وقد كنتم به تستعجلون. And Allah said the same ayah to Fir'aun. الآن وقد عصيت قبل وكنت من المفسدين. Now يا خربان. Now, al-an. You have to recite it in the Quran like this. Al-an. Or, al-an. Yeah, you can make this heel or mad. وَقَدْ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَقَدْ عَصَيْتَ You've been disobeying Allah before. And he was one of the corruptors. Now, فَسَيِّدْنَا جِبْرِيَيْلَ or Jibreel عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ He was telling Rasulullah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Muhammad, listen. Do you know if you see me when Fir'aun was sinking and drowning, dying, while he used to say, I believe, and I get the mud of the Red Sea, I used to put it in his mouth. Maybe the mercy of Allah will touch him or come to him. That's why Sayyidina Jibreel, he used to hate Fir'aun. He said, he was sinking, and they used to get the mud, I used to put it on his mouth. I did not want him to say, I believe in Allah. But anyway, we have to finish away. Showing us, yani, during that time, Allah will not accept the iman from anybody. Yeah, that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah accept your tawbah from you until the sun will appear from the west and your ruh will reach your throat. During that time, خلاص, that's it. Your tawbah will not be accepted. And when also the beast will appear, this major signs of the day of judgment, during that time, لا ينفع نفس الإيمان ولم تكن آمنت من قبل أو كسبت في إيمانها خير. Somebody was not praying, Muslim. He never prayed. And subhanAllah, the sun appeared from the west, or the beast appeared to the people. The beast, this is the دابة. سبحان الله. the beast. And what happened to him? He will say, I will go now, I make tawbah, I will go to the masjid for salah. His salah is over, ya habibi, khalas. Even the masjid is still open, but Allah will not accept his tawbah. Khalas, Allah said, لا ينفع نفسا إيمانها لم تكن أمنت من قبل. It's over. You already see the signs. That's a major signs. Your iman will not benefit you. Like Fir'aun during that time. Verse number 52. ثم قيل للذين ظلموا ذوقوا عذاب الخلد هل تجزون إلا بما كنتم تكسبون. Verse number 50. I said number 50, right? 51. Yes. أثم إذا ما وقع آمنتم به الآن وقد كنتم به تستعجلون. This 51. Is it only when the punishment has befallen you that you will believe in it? Allah is asking. It will be said to you at that time, have you believed now while you hasten it in mockery that it should come sooner? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, while you are hastening and you're mocking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, making fun of him, يلا 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 ask your God to send the punishment right now. This is what he said to Rasulullah. Allah said, tell them that. Okay, what are you going to do if Allah punish you and he send his punishment, like sudden punishment to you? At night while you are sleeping, ghafil, don't know what's happening to you, or during the day you are, you've been occupied and busy in your dunya. Do you have time to repent during the time? Even if you have time to repent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept your repentance. Subhanallah. See verse number 52. ثم قيل للذين ظلموا ذوقوا عذاب الخلد هل تجزون إلا بما كنتم تكسبون. Verse 52, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, then it will be said to the unjust, the ظالمين, those who were unjust against Allah, against his creatures, against themselves. Then it will be said to the unjust, taste you the punishment of eternity. ذوقوا عذاب الخلد. In the hellfire, are you being recompensed except for what you used to earn? Subhanallah. هل تجزون إلا بما كنتم تكسبون. The meaning, يا جماعة, here, subhanallah, those who were unjust in this dunya, worldly life, against themselves, against the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these people, they will be banished for eternity in the hereafter. And they will be in the punishment of Allah in Jahannam forever. مؤبد. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهَا عَلَيْهِمْ مُؤْصَدَةً. يعني مؤصدة. If the kuffar will be into the hellfire, there is no exit there. For eternity. They will be punished for eternity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not zalim, ya jama'a. Allah is so just, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these people, they will be punished because Allah sent the message with the Rasul. And Allah supported that Rasul with the miracles. And they saw the miracles. And if somebody saw the miracles and he denied, he will be punished. And while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them too many chances and respite, and they did not believe. عذاب الدنيا, the punishment of الدنيا for those who are disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, humiliation. But عذاب الدنيا موقوت for certain time. It is not forever. And but عذاب الآخرة for eternity. I'm talking about the kuffar, those who denied the messengers, those who been supported by the miracles, and this is what their hands earned. Subhanallah. Last ayah with me tonight, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَسْتَنْبِئُونَكَ أحق هو لسه ستيل إن داوت لا إله إلا الله ويستنبئونك أحق هو قل إي وربي إنه الحق وما أنتم بمعجزين. Verse number 53. And they asked you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, يستنبئونك, remember سورة النبأ, عما يتساءلون عنه, النبأ العظيم, يستنبئونك. والنبأ الخبر العظيم. It is not just يعني normal information. To tell me, what did you eat last night? What are you gonna go tomorrow? This is called خبر, information. But النبأ about something great. نبأ like the day of judgment. عما يتساءلون. What they ask you, oh Muhammad? عن النبأ العظيم about the day of judgment. That نبأ. ويستنبئونك. They ask you about something important. أحق هو. And they ask you, O Muhammad, to inform them about Allah's punishment, number one, on the day of resurrection, saying, is it true? They were in doubt even about that, the day of judgment, punishment. Subhanallah. Say, yes, yes, by my Lord, Iwa Rabbi. It's a qasam. قل إي وربي قسم. ويستنبئونك أحق هو. قل إي وربي. قل إي وربي إنه الحق وما أنتم بمعجزين. Yes, by my Lord, it is true. You cannot escape it. وما أنتم بمعجزين. And you will be under the control of Allah. Under his, صلى الله عليه وسلم, أحق هو. What is who means? Who in Arabic can carry too many meanings, يا جماعة. I said it in my tafsir Nur al-Bayan, the punishment of al-akhirah. Because they ask for dunya punishment. And when he told them, so when he told them, you will be punished in the hereafter, they said, is it true too? We're going to be punished there. Okay, this is one thing. Number two, who in the Quran means they asking you, O Muhammad, is it true? The Quran is true. The religion of Islam, is it true? Al-Nubuwa, is it true? Your prophethood, al-Tashri'ah, is it true? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a Nabi, is he true? Al-Qiyamah, the day of Al-Qiyamah, is it true? Al-Ba'ath, the day of resurrection, who means this ma'ani, these meanings? Is it true? Allah will humiliate these infidels and Allah will grant victory to the mu'mineen. Is it true? The punishment of the hereafter, is it true? قُلْ إِي وَرَبِّي. Say yes, I swear by Rabb, by my Lord. Is it true? Is it true? Allah will resurrect us and will gather us to gather at the day of judgment. Tell them yes. There is no doubt about that. It's 100% true, and you cannot escape from this punishment in the hereafter. Allah, the one who did create you while you were nothing, it's easy for Him to recreate you again. كذلك يعيدكم مرة أخرى. سبحان الله. كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده وعدا علينا إن كنا فاعلين. والله even يا جماعة, you all mean ما شاء الله, you've been circumcised, right? That's gonna come back to you. غرل المحجلين, they're gonna come back to you. Somebody lost his arm or eye during the dunya, Allah will bring him with complete, with his eyes, with his hand, everything. كما بدأنا, the way Allah created you, He will bring you the day of judgment. كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده. Same. وعدا علينا إن كنا فاعلين. فأنتم في قبضة الله وسلطانه ونبي. الله سبحانه وتعالى, this السماوات والأرض belong to Him. سبحانه وإليه ترجعون. You will return back to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. What should we do? Anybody still denying Allah, the Sunnah, the Deen, the Quran, even those Muslims who escaped from Islam, you cannot escape from the punishment of Allah in the day of judgment. Those who are not praying, those who are away from Allah, those who are not listening, those who are in doubt about the deen, the sunnah, the Quran, the grave, all of these people, they have to fear Allah. Otherwise, the three, four ayat I've been talking today, for those who are denying, like exactly likewise the people of Mecca, they denied Rasulullah, they denied Islam, Al-Quran, they denied his prophethood, they denied the day of resurrection, they denied the Sirat and the Mizan. Like this Kharban, he's claiming, his Sheikh, that Al-Kayali. He said, there is no Sirat. Sirat is something ma'nawi, spiritual. To follow the deen of Allah, لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاتَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. عَمِلَ كِدْ. He's like, صِرَاتَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. The Shaitan is sitting above the Sirat there. You're stupid. You doesn't understand. الصراط المستقيم. We are asking Allah 17 times in our salah, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Every day in our salah, guide, oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. What is the straight path? There is a straight path, physical in the hereafter, and ma'nawi, spiritual, in this dunya. If you will be in الصراط المستقيم in this dunya, the spiritual one, this the deen, Islam, the Quran, the way of Allah, this is الصراط المستقيم, you will be guided. Allah will facilitate it for you to be easy to pass that sirat al-mustaqim, the physical one, the bridge above Jahannam in the hereafter. He doesn't understand what I'm saying now. بقول لك لأقعدن لهم صراطك المستقيم. الشيطان is sitting where? Above sirat al-mustaqim, above Jahannam. Stupid, because he did not study the rules. He did not say, he read some from Google and he make himself a sheikh. I don't know these people crazy, والله, social media. See, فاحنا we have to know the army is guiding too many people. You don't know. If you see this man, millions of followers, millions. Why? They grow him up, they put him in the, Dubai in Emirates in this TV, and they make him big sheikh while he's zero. He's a مدرس teacher, just teaching science, whatever. And physics, yeah, physics, says Ali Arif. We see in Egypt also, a lot of Kharbanin they came. It is not just the, because his country, no. I did not mean any country, no. The person himself, because when you see somebody, he's claiming he's alim and he's misguiding people, this is a big problem. Do you know, brothers, if Sayyid Jum'ah making sin between me and Allah, this is on my shoulder. But if I'm standing in the masjid or in the social media, giving them wrong information about deen, this is big musibah. This is big musibah. Yes, yes, misguidance. Changing the deen of Allah in different way. Jazakumullah khair for listening and forgive me.